Hey guys, so if you're building a web page and you're finding that the length of the page is just way too long and could really benefit from inserting a floating back to top button, I'm going to show you today how to exactly insert that using GeneratePress. All right, so let's jump into my demo site. And what we're first going to do is go to Appearance and Customize. So the beauty of this is GeneratePress has a back to top button feature enabled within the theme. So how we control that is come to layout and go to footer. And just below the footer widgets, you'll see back to top button. So we can go ahead and just toggle that drop down into enable. So now we'll see as we scroll down this page, that back to top button, it just appeared, which is perfect and exactly what we want. So we can click it and it'll jump right back up. So what we can do to kind of take this even a step further is we can play with that back to top button. We can style it, we can change its color, we can move it. If you find that it's too far in the corner, by default, it is pretty darn close to the edge. So what we can do is jump on over to writing some CSS and we can adjust it. So the class is generate back to top. And we want to say generate back to top visited. So this is going to allow us, what we're first going to do is just move it around. And this is coming straight actually from the GeneratePress documentation. I'm happy to link to this in the video description below. Settings we want to adjust here, the CSS we want to use is for bottom and left, right? So, or right, right? So depending where you want it. Right now it's in the bottom right. So what we can say is we'll say bottom 100 pixels. And now you saw it jump up. And then we can say right 100 pixels. So now it's much further in on the page. Of course, I think that's probably a little bit overkill, but I'm just demoing to you what the possibilities are for being able to move it. All right, so next what we can do is you can actually change the colors of this back to dot button. If you have GeneratePress Premium, it's already built in. So you can come back to colors. And we scroll all the way down to the bottom where it says back to top. Open up that drop down and we can go ahead and play with this. So I want to change this to a blue and on hover, I want it to be a gray and we'll leave that as white. So perfect. Now that's updated. Now what we can do also, if you do not have premium, you can definitely go ahead and just insert some CSS here. You say background color and insert your hex code there. It'll work great. All right, so next what we can do is go ahead and adjust maybe the size of this back to top button. So if we'll again come back to the same exact set class and we can say width, we'll say 75 pixels. We'll say height, 75 pixels. So now we have a real massive buttons, but of course our arrow now is towards the top. So what we can say is line height 75 pixels, and that'll push that arrow right back to the center for us. And then we can actually change the border radius. So let's make this a circle. So we'll say 500 pixels, just to always do a max out on that, just to make it a circle, which looks good. All right, so that pretty much takes us as far as we can go here on the styling it via CSS. Now there's a couple of additional tweaks we can make to this back to top button, including how fast you scroll back to the top and how far from the top it appears, right? So at a certain point when you start scrolling, it pops up. You can actually change that so it'll appear sooner or maybe later. So let's go ahead and jump into that. What we have to do is come back to our dashboard and go to our theme file editor and go to our theme functions file here. All right, so I'm gonna grab this code from GeneratePress and paste this in. So this is an add filter, return 400, and this is in milliseconds. So we can go ahead and say 200, let's say, for example. If we go ahead and update that, come to our site and scroll down and click it. It went very fast, right? Because we cut the time that it goes back to the top in half. So if we did 1,000 milliseconds, suddenly this is going to take quite a while, as it should. There it goes. Perfect. So you can really play with that if you like it to be slower or faster, maybe depending on your audience and what would be best for them. Now, the next part that I mentioned was about how far you have to scroll before that arrow appears. I'm going to grab this code from GeneratePress again, documentation. We'll paste in this PHP. Again, the link to the documentation is in the description below. So this is adding a filter for the scroll, and it's setting the number of pixels that you scroll from the top before it appears. So if we go ahead and just say 50 pixels, this is essentially, we barely should have to scroll at all before it pops up. So see, boom, there it is, 50 pixels, and it appears. Now, if we want to wait a while before that comes up, we can change that to 600, and that'll be 600 pixels. So we scroll a bit, and there's 600 pixels there. So again, it's really nice that you can adjust those settings to kind of cater that back to top button for your site and your audience and what's best for you. All right, so I hope you found that useful in kind of exploring the back to top feature within GeneratePress. I'll be honest, I don't use it a whole lot, really, rarely ever, but I think that's probably because I don't normally build pages that are quite lengthy that would require it. However, I do think it is a useful feature that can come in handy in the right scenario. Thanks again for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe to my channel below. Appreciate the support.